Hey everybody, Justin Mead here. It's Wednesday, February 3rd, and this is where we're at. Just like last week, I'm going to walk you through some of the reports that give you some insights into what's happening in real estate, and then we'll end by taking a look at the bond market. We'll start off with sales. New home sales, which measures signed contracts on new homes, were up 1.6% in December, which was slightly lower than expectations. Sales are still up 15% year over year, and the median home price was reported at $355,900, up 8% year over year. Moving to unemployment, let's look at initial and continuing jobless claims. Initial jobless claims, which measures individuals filing for unemployment benefits for the first time, decreased by 67,000 to 847,000, but still remains at extremely elevated levels. Continuing claims, or those that continue to receive benefits, decreased by 203,000 to 4.7 million. This ties well into the ADP employment report that showed there were 147,000 jobs created in the month of January, which was stronger than the 50,000 expected. Take this with a grain of salt, though, because we weren't even making a dent in making up the millions of jobs that were lost due to the pandemic. Pending home sales, which measures signed contracts on existing homes, were flat in December, but it was the highest December reading ever. Year-over-year pending sales are up 21%, which is amazing in the face of record low inventory levels, which are down 23% from last year. CoreLogic released their home price index report for December, showing that home prices increased 1% during the month and 9.2% year-over-year. This is a significant gain from the 8.2% year-over-year number reported last month and was the highest annual home price gain since February 2014. Let's take a look at the bond market, and it's a good time to look as we're seeing a lot of movement right now. It's 4:33 p.m. and we're down 22 basis points, breaking through the Fibonacci level that has been providing some resistance. This breakthrough will put lenders in a position to potentially issue a reprice for the worse, causing rates to increase midday. We can expect rates to start the day higher tomorrow, should there not be a reprice today. Even with a reprice, rates are still historically low, and with the combination of low inventory levels and high home values, it's never been a better time to sell or refinance a home. That's all for this week's Where We At report. If you like what you heard and want to hear more, be sure to hit the subscribe button below, and as always, feel free to reach out with any questions.